To our next question, we've got candidates from Welladay and from Kamloops. And our fourth question is, federal projections for mining exploration show that the Northwest Territories is one of only two jurisdictions in Canada where investment is decreasing. In contrast, our neighbours in the Yukon and in Nunavut and potentially most of the rest of the world are experiencing phenomenal growth in their exploration industries because of historically high mineral prices. Do you find this disconcerting? And if you are elected, what would you do to increase mineral investment in the Northwest Territories? And our first candidate will be Bob Bromley of Welladay.
Thank you, Jocelyn. As usual, I highly question the premise of this question as the others. However, I think I'd start with some context. First of all, we have doubled our GDP several times over in the Northwest Territories, whereas Nunavut and Yukon haven't. I think they would trade places with us at any time. Our GDP is up here, theirs is down here. Theirs is increasing rapidly, while ours isn't right now. But that's been our history, is a bunch of ups and downs, booms and busts. So we are much better off despite this. I think some of the things we can do, however, are to offer training and certainly work cooperatively with our Aboriginal governments, who are becoming bigger and bigger players in this field. We certainly need to provide certainty for investors, and one of the areas here is the environmental management regime. There have been quite a number of recommendations over the years from the various federal reviews, and of course this is a federal process, so all we can do is try and influence this. But one of the big problems is the federal government fails to appoint people to boards. So of course those positions are left open to the point that there's not even a quorum to meet. We are still lacking land use planning in a big way. That needs to be completed. And of course we're not funding the boards that we have to the order that they're required.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Bromley. Our second Welladay candidate is Mark Bogan.
Certainly what's resonating within this riding is unsettled land claims and devolution. I guess those two pieces could and should conclude during the next assembly, and that people start working in harmony with each other. I think that would help clear up some of the issues regarding the mining sector and so on. Let's face it, that's going to be the major industry in the North, has been and will be the major industry in the Northwest Territories. It's a good industry as long as it's managed well and that all stakeholders are treated equitably and fairly and given compassion and that all voices are heard. So those are the two big ones. This all spills into what everybody's talking about, land use planning and how we've gone on for so long with these issues that, again, at the end of the day, our next government should really focus on finishing unsettled land claim settlements here in the North and the devolution process, in order that everybody can have a wonderful, healthy, lovely life, and again, live in harmony and come up with equitable and fair solutions. Thank you.
Thank you. We have two more candidates on this question, our candidates from Kamloops. And just a reminder on the question and whether or not you agree with the premise of the question. In the end, the question is, if you were elected, what would you do to increase mineral investment in the Northwest Territories? Dave Ramsey of Kamloops.
Yeah, thank you very much, Jocelyn. I certainly agree with the premise of this question. I think it's a competitive environment that we're dealing with. And the reality is our economy is losing out. We're losing those investment dollars, the exploration dollars that have gone elsewhere. We need to try to get them back. Now, what can we do, the incoming government? And that's the question. And others up here have spoken about it. We need a mineral development strategy first and foremost. We have to increase the regulatory certainty surrounding development. There have been no meaningful results out of the Neil McCrank report or John Pollard's work. We need to settle this issue with Ottawa. And the problem is Ottawa has too much control in the Northwest Territories today. We have to, one of the first things the next government should do is settle this. We need to clarify consultation parameters with Aboriginal groups around the Northwest Territories. And finally, Jocelyn, we need to do a much better job at promoting the Northwest Territories. We have to get out there. No one else is going to do that for us. We have to get out there. We have to be champions of what we have here and develop the resources. Anybody that thinks that the future of the Northwest Territories isn't going to be based on resource extraction of some type or another is fooling themselves. Thank you.
Thank you. And our final candidate on this question is Brian Sutherland of Camlink.
Thank you. Thank you. I agree that the mining industry is our main economy, that the idea of diversification right now as the mines are closing down is a distraction. If there are six mines on the horizon, we know that there are regulatory problems. Why are we not able to just fast track them? How come we can't just list the mines, figure out what the problems are, and get it done? Again, everybody says there's regulation problems. Sounds like everybody agrees that there's a revenue problem, and the way to change that is to increase revenues through mining. So I just can't understand how come we can't get it done. And then my other problem is, do we or do we not have a debt problem? If we're borrowing another $300 million on top of $600 million, and half of that is already spent, we think you're going to come around again for another $300 million. Where does it end? What is the plan to wind down the spending, if not to grow our main industry and increase those revenues? And why are we having this conversation now instead of these past 4 years and ready to move forward? Thank you.
Thank you, Brian.